Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome everyone to our event today, and we wanted something particularly special at this corner because not only is it next to the Palladium, it's in the center of our new downtown. Why did we pick Homage to Hoagy? As I think most of you know, Hoagy Carmichael is a famous composer of the 20th century and from Indiana. In fact, wrote his most famous work, the most recorded song ever in the history of the world, Stardust, in Bloomington, Indiana. And so the sculpture you see behind you was inspired by the lyrics to Stardust. You have abstract stars, moons, and musical notes. It gives me great pleasure to welcome to the podium our sculptor, Arlon Bayliss.
Thank you, Matt. It's been an honor researching Carmichael's life and work, from his beginnings in poverty, to his fascination with early jazz, to his later career as a songwriter, singer, actor, and radio star. In Homage to Hoagy, I not only wanted to illustrate recurring lyrical themes in Carmichael's compositions, stars, stardust, moons, moonlight, but also to express his exuberant response to and his joyful love of jazz music as described in his two autobiographies. The gramophone horn refers to his early exposure to music. Hoagy wrote of how he wore out several 78 RPM records back in the early days, playing them again and again. The moons and stars refer not only to his song lyrics, but also to the stardom he enjoyed in the golden years of Hollywood. I tilted the sculpture towards the Palladium to visually connect the artwork and its home. Hidden in the composition is a single skylark, a reference to the title of one of Carmichael's most famous compositions. At night, the sculpture is illuminated from within by hidden light sources that bathe the stems, the stars, and the moons with colored light. The mayor, recognizing that visitors could not walk up to the sculpture, suggested educational interactive kiosks. They are styled on vintage gramophones and feature crank handles that activate 14 different digital clips of well-known Carmichael compositions. And my hope is that Homage to Hoagy becomes a cultural landmark, a fitting tribute to Hoagy Carmichael that brings joy to the citizens of Carmel and visitors to the Center for the Performing Arts for many, many years to come. Thank you.
I want to thank you on behalf of the Songbook Foundation for honoring one of our country's greatest composers. We often refer to the Great American Songbook as the soundtrack of our lives. Well, when you hear the music that is featured here in the Homage to Hoagy sculpture and kiosks, songs like Georgia on My Mind, Skylark, and of course, Stardust, there can be no debate about the importance of Hoagy Carmichael to American music. We are proud to honor him and celebrate him in the Great American Songbook, and we are so thrilled to have this sculpture here in the heart of the city of Carmel. It just proves and signifies that Carmel really is the home of the Great American Songbook. Thank you.
I should point out too, if you're wandering around this area, there's another kiosk just to the east as well, just identical to this one. Thank you for coming today.
Here's Peggy Lee.